And on the other side, we still have this e to the sine x cosine x. Any questions so far? So now we're going to integrate both sides. On the left-hand side, we're just integrating this derivative. On the right-hand side, we're integrating the e to the sine x cosine x. That one can be done with a simple u substitution, correct? What would we want to let u equal here? U would be sine, so du would be cosine. And so really, you just end up integrating e to the u du, right? So now, here the integral and the derivative cancel. So we have e to the sine x times y. And then on the other side, that's just going to integrate to e to the sine x. And of course we have a constant there. Is it easy to get y by itself here? Yeah. So we divide out the e to the sine x. That's going to give us 1 plus c e to the negative sine of x. Let's put in our initial condition. We know that y is 2 when x is pi. What is the sine of pi? 0. And we know e to the 0 is just 1. So that means 2 is going to equal 1 plus c. So what do we know c has to be? That's an equal, so not a, let me fix that. So then our final solution is going to be 1 plus e to the negative sine x. Okay. Any questions so far? All right, let's look at one that's a little bit uglier. Just so, you know, we won't do just easy examples in class. All right, so let's go to problem number 25. It's the one I want to look at next.